Let's take a look at Live's preferences window. This is a section with many tabs for you to adjust the way that Live looks and behaves. To do this, simply go to the drop-down Live menu and select Preferences. Alternatively, you can use the shortcut Command comma on a Mac or Control comma on Windows. The Preferences window is divided into tab sections. These are as follows: Look, Feel, Audio, Link Tempo MIDI, File Folder, Library, Plugins, Record Warp Launch, and Licenses Maintenance. Look Feel allows you to set up Live's language using the chooser. The Zoom Display slider allows you to zoom Live's screen from 50% up to 200%. The next section allows you to set track and clip colors when using Live. In the section directly below, labeled Customization, you can select themes, which change the overall appearance of Live. You can also change the brightness, color intensity, color hue, and grid line intensity of Live's user interface. The Audio tab is split into four sections: Audio Device, which covers drivers and the audio interface selection, as well as input and output configuration. Under Sample Rate, you can set the overall sample rate of your audio interface. And under Latency, you can adjust the latency of your interface. In the last section, Test, you can simulate a CPU load to make sure that the latency set for your audio interface doesn't produce audio artifacts. The next tab, Link Tempo MIDI, is split into three sections. Link allows you to set preferences for Ableton Link. Tempo Follower allows you to enable or disable Live's tempo following feature, as well as select an input source to control Live's tempo. It's worth noting that Link, Tempo Follower, and External Sync are mutually exclusive features. For instance, activating Tempo Follower will deactivate Link. The MIDI section allows you to select control surfaces, takeover mode, and MIDI ports. In the File Folder tab, you can select another sample editing software to use with Live, and you can set the location of your temporary folder, as well as the location and size of your decoding cache. The Library tab allows you to set the browser behavior in Live, as well as choose locations for content. The Plugins tab allows you to choose settings for your third-party plugins. You can enable or disable audio units, access your system VST folders, and set up a custom folder for your VST plugins, as well as asking Live to rescan for plugins should they not have appeared in your browser. The Record Warp Launch tab allows you to set parameters for recording, warp behavior, and launching of clips. Notable options here include setting the file type and bit depth of your recordings, an option to automatically create fades on clip edges, and toggling of pitch lock when drawing MIDI notes. Finally, under Licenses and Maintenance, you can authorize your version of Live both online and offline.